What's up, nutrition nerds, and welcome back to another video. And today we're going to talk about the vegetarian diet, protein, and endurance athletes. Now, protein is one of those things that gets a lot of media hype and coverage. And now there are a bucket load of supplements aimed at vegetarians and vegetarian athletes. What I want to cover today is whether vegetarian athletes need to be aware of anything in relation to protein compared to their meat-eating companions. And we're going to answer two questions today. Can vegetarian athletes get enough good quality protein in their diet? And do they need to eat more protein than meat eaters? Along with the answer to those questions, I'm going to give you an awesome little rhyme to help you with your veggie protein intake. So as usual here at Nutrition Triathlon, let's just go over a bit of basic science to give you some background. If you don't want to listen to that and just want to skip ahead, then you can find the chapters in the play bar and just skip to where you want. Before we get started, I just wanted to mention that I'm doing this video in partnership with hurrythefoodup.com. Hurry the Food Up are an awesome company who I work with, and I help make sure that the nutritional advice and information that they give on their recipes is up to scratch. They created a vegetarian high-protein meal plan, which I cast my eye over and I think it's great. And if you're interested, you can find a link in the description and you can download it. There are two plans, one for weight loss and one which is geared towards muscle building and maintenance. They aren't specifically for endurance athletes, but the plans contain some delicious recipes and you could adapt them and tailor them to your needs. I'll be working more with them in the future and we'll be adding to these plans, so make sure you sign up to their newsletter if you haven't already. And if you're new to this channel at this point, then press the subscribe button to stay up to date with everything that I release. Alrighty, let's get back to it. A lot of people think about protein being involved with muscle building and maintenance. It is, but it's involved in so much more too. Our body relies on protein. Our enzymes, lots of our hormones, and our immune system all function because of protein. So protein is vital just for a healthy functioning body. There are little subunits of protein, if you will, and these are called amino acids. And these amino acids are joined up in different combinations and different lengths. And this is what helps to create the structure and function of a protein. Some of these amino acids we can make ourselves, but some of them we have to get through our diet. The ones we have to get through our diet are called essential amino acids because we can't make them ourselves. And this is super important for a veggie, as I'll explain. The other thing to talk about is protein bioavailability. This means how easily the protein is digested and absorbed by the body. And it's another idea for veggies to be aware of. Some protein is absorbed more easily than others. Now, these two concepts are why historically there's been concerns about the vegetarian diet. That vegetarian athletes don't get enough of the essential amino acids in their diet, and that they can't absorb plant protein well enough. So, with those two concepts in mind, let's answer our questions from the start and debunk some myths, shall we? So the quick and simple answer here is that if you're eating a varied, healthy, balanced diet, then yes, it's absolutely possible for a vegetarian athlete to get enough good quality protein in their diet. Now, it's true that vegetarians are at a bit of a disadvantage compared to meat eaters when it comes to getting enough good quality protein in their diet. Animal-based proteins contain all of the essential amino acids in sufficient quantity for our body to use, whereas often plant-based proteins don't. There are some exceptions here, and these are things like quinoa, buckwheat, or soy. But other plant-based proteins don't contain that whole profile of the essential amino acids in sufficient quantity, which is where you get the term incomplete protein from. Now, is this an issue? Not with a varied, balanced, and healthy diet. Your body is a clever thing, and if you eat from a range of plant-based protein over the course of the day, your body is perfectly happy with this. So you don't need to specifically combine protein sources in a meal. A great way to remember to eat different protein sources throughout the day is with the following rhyme: a grain, a green, and a bean. This doesn't have to be for every meal, it's just a helpful little mantra that you could use to eat varied sources throughout the day. Animal-based sources like dairy or eggs contain that whole essential amino acid profile, So if you're a vegetarian that eats those kind of food sources regularly, then you're in an even better place when it comes to protein. So the answer to the question of, can you veggies get enough good quality protein in your diet? Yes, you can. The average protein need for athletes is higher than the general population, with current guidelines suggesting that endurance athletes should eat somewhere between 1.2 to 2 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight per day. To answer the question of whether vegetarians need to eat more protein than meat eaters, we have to go back to the bioavailability part that I mentioned. The protein in animal-based products is generally better digested and absorbed by the body. And so the amount of protein that you gain through plant-based sources is, on a gram-for-gram basis, relatively lower. And depending on which scoring system you use, it's generally around 20 to 40% less available. Now, there isn't much guidance available for vegetarian protein intake for athletes because there's a lack of research. As a personal view, I think that vegetarians who are eating a lower amount of animal-based protein, rather than aiming for that lower amount of 1.2 grams per kilogram of body weight per day, should aim somewhere around the 2 grams per kilogram of body weight a day instead. For the 70 kilogram athlete, that would be about 140 grams of protein per day. This might sound like a lot, but we know it's perfectly safe, and it's important because it helps to recover from that hard training or racing that you've done. Now, it's not very practical or very fun to count calories or macronutrients every day. My take-home message for vegetarian athletes is that if you're eating mostly plant-based sources of protein and you're training for performance, then it might be worth just aiming to up your protein intake slightly. If you include animal-based products, then you don't need to worry as much. But overall dietary quality is so important, so make sure that you do eat a healthy, varied diet. And if you do and you follow that rhyme, you'll put yourself in a great position when it comes to protein intake and generally being healthy. And that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you found it useful. And if you did, then I'd really appreciate it if you gave the video a like. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions or if you've got any specific topics you'd like me to go over in the future. And I'll catch you next time. See ya.